and thank you for joining me here at Why the Book Wins, where I compare books with their movie adaptations. My name is Laura, and the other day I posted a book first movie for the Daphne du Maurier novel Rebecca, comparing it with the 1940 Alfred Hitchcock adaptation, which, by the way, my beautiful Folio Society of Rebecca is right here. Anyway, I recently watched the 2020 adaptation, so I thought I would film a shorter follow-up video talking about my thoughts about the 2020 movie. And so there will be spoilers for the book, the 2020 movie, as well as the 1940 movie, so I'll be just kind of talking about all of them, but the focus will primarily be on the 2020 movie and my problems with it, which I prefer to be more positive on my channel and not be like complaining about my problems with different books or movies for the most part, especially if it's like, I don't want to sound pretentious with issues with certain books and act like I'm above it or something, so I don't want to come across that way. And obviously, especially with a book, like that is someone, because editors are involved, but primarily it's one person just putting so much of themselves into a book, and so much work goes into writing a book, and it tends to be pretty personal for the most part, depending. And so I don't like insulting books, even if it's one I don't like. I try to not be too harsh with it. And same with movies, which that's obviously a bigger production and more people involved, but still, you know, a lot of care goes into most movies. Some movies I feel like they're just in it for the money and they don't really seem to care. But anyway, so I try not to be too harsh or too critical for the most part and just be more positive. But having said that, I did have a lot of issues with this movie because I feel like they just fundamentally changed the book and like the message and the purpose of the book. And so even though a lot of the plot like is the same as the book, like just the message overall was just completely changed. And I will start with the casting of Armie Hammer. So Armie Hammer is only 3 years older than Lily James, who plays the narrator. And the age difference was a huge part of the book. So Maxim is like 20, 23 years older than the narrator. So he has experienced so much more of life than she has. And she almost views him as this like authoritative father figure in a way. And that was just a huge part, is just how much older he was. And he was married to Rebecca for what, like 15 years? Whereas because Armie Hammer is so much younger, like he couldn't have been married to Rebecca for that long. And he and the narrator are on like the same level playing field because they're around the same age. There is like the wealth gap because he is wealthy and she's not, so you do have that. But I felt like their dynamic was just completely changed in part because he was so much younger and he was like the same age as her, essentially. Even in the 1940 movie, Olivier was 10 years older than Fontaine, plus they added like gray streaks in his hair to make him appear even older. And it's also important because when he was married to Rebecca, you know, they were around the same age and she was just like so smart and in control and probably made Maxim feel less masculine in a way because she was so assertive. And so it makes sense he would want to find someone considerably younger, like over 20 years younger. That way he could feel more secure with himself and feeling older and more mature and more knowledgeable than his new wife, who was so young. Which, by the way, I want to recommend the cover to credits episode for Rebecca, where they compare the book with the 1940 adaptation. I thought it was a great episode. I listened to it after recording my original book first movie, but I will link to it because I love their show and you should definitely check them out. They do the same thing, but comparing books and movies, and they go a bit more in depth because their episodes are a bit longer. And so I enjoy hearing their coverage and their opinions, and they're more detailed when it comes to the plot than I am because I keep these so short. But anyway, so check out Cover to Credits. But anyway, back to, you know, my book first movie. So my other problem is that Maxim de Winter in the book, like he is as cold as his last name. Like the naming of the characters in this book are very significant. Whereas in the movie, he was just like very playful and lighthearted. And when they show up at Mandalay, like he's picking her up and they're laughing and being silly. And that was just not how he was in the book. He was just very serious and not playful. And also in the movie, in the 2020 movie, we see them like being intimate with each other. Like there's no sex scenes, but we do see them in bed and, you know, presumably they are being intimate. Whereas in the book, there is like evidence to suggest that they were not having sex up until he confesses the truth about Rebecca, because in that scene it talks about how like they kiss passionately for the first time or something along those lines. But also there's a part in the book where she's considering buying new undergarments because hers are just like old and not in good shape. But then she doesn't, because she's like, you know, what's the point? I'm the only one who sees them, so I may as well just keep my old ones. And that does make sense in the book too, because they did barely know each other. They'd known each other a week before they got married, so it kind of makes sense they would be taking it slow anyway. But that was another change to the 2020 movie. And speaking of the truth about Rebecca. So in the book, we find out that Maxim had shot Rebecca. And in the 1940 movie, like, he doesn't shoot her, but instead, when he is confronting her, she conveniently trips and falls and she hits her head and dies. And in my book first movie, I said that they could not have Maxim kill Rebecca because she was, like, presumably pregnant. And so they couldn't have that happen, which that might have contributed to it. But it's actually because the code at the time said that anyone who commits a crime has to be punished for it. And so if they had Maxim kill her, he would need to be punished in one way or another, either end up in prison or go to jail or be killed or something. Someone could not get away with doing a crime. And so they wanted the ending to be like the book and have the two of them being together as Mandalay burns. And so they instead had to have him not kill her and have it be an accident. So here in the 2020 movie, they stay true to the novel and they do have Maxim kill Rebecca. However, when he like tells the narrator about all of this, the scene was just kind of weird. Like, he is telling the narrator about that night and how he confronted Rebecca and how he had a gun and how, like, she was telling him to shoot her, which he did. But when he's telling her this, he gives the gun to the narrator and he has her pointing it at him. And it's like he's asking her to kill him, but then she doesn't. And it was just a weird scene. And I was like, what is going on here? Especially compared to the Alfred Hitchcock movie, because the scene where in Laurence Olivier in that movie where he confesses the truth is such a fantastic scene. And the way the camera work is done there, like, it's incredible. So especially when you're comparing the two movies together, the 1940 movie did that scene so much better. And then I, of course, need to talk about Mrs. Danvers, because in the 2020 movie, the narrator, like, confronts Danvers very early on, because, of course, Danvers does not like the narrator and is very cold and mean to her. And so early on in the movie, she goes up to Danvers' headquarters and tells her that she needs to be out the next day and that she's fired. However, Danvers opens up to her and is vulnerable and is like, I don't know what to do with my life. Like, Mandalay is my life. And, you know, I don't know what to do if I can't be working here. And, you know, I would have helped you, but you've never asked. And so the narrator is then like, well, I'm asking now, like, you can help me and we can work together. And, you know, you can teach me the ropes of Mandalay. And so it seems like they have turned a new leaf and that they are working together and everything is fine. And then when it's time for the costume party, her maid tells her that she should dress up as the ancestor Caroline de Winter. And then, of course, when she shows up and everybody is shocked and Maxim is upset, she runs upstairs and the maid tells her like, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't know Danvers is the one who gave me the idea. Where, of course, in the book, Danvers gave her the idea. She didn't like tell it to a maid and have the maid tell her. But also the scene where she walks down the stairs and reveals the dress, it just wasn't quite as suspenseful as the book or the movie. Like in the book, leading up to the reveal with this dress, like it was just so suspenseful and you knew it wasn't gonna go well. And so you're just waiting like to see what's gonna happen. And the movie also, the 1940 movie did a great job at having the narrator is just so excited about this dress and when she walks down the stairs and it was just incredible. So I feel like the 2020 movie just didn't quite measure up to that. And then she has her like one-on-one interactions with Danvers in Rebecca's room the two times, just like she does in the book in the 1940 movie. But here, Kristen Scott Thomas plays Danvers, and I liked her. However, when you compare her with Judith Anderson, who is in the 1940 movie, Judith Anderson was like incredible as Danvers, and she was so unsettling, and just like the obsession and like the passion as she talked about Rebecca was just fantastic. And so these scenes in the 2020 movie just didn't have that unease, and she didn't quite seem quite as obsessed. And then also the narrator in these scenes didn't seem quite as upset. Like in the book and in the 1940 movie, the narrator is like so distraught and uncomfortable and is wanting to get out of there. And so I feel like that just wasn't conveyed as well in those moments. And then moving on to the retrial when they find Rebecca's body. So in the book and in the 1940 movie, we have Favelle who has a note that Rebecca wrote him, and he confronts Maxim and he's like, hey, I have this note that proves Rebecca didn't commit suicide. So if you pay me, you know, this amount of money, I will keep the note a secret. But in the book, in the 1940 movie, Maxim does not fall for that. And he's like, no, I'll call the cops right now. And you can just tell them directly, I'm not going to be blackmailed. I'm not falling for this. So he kind of turns it on to Favelle. And it was a really cool moment for Maxim because it shows his strength, I guess. Whereas in the 2020 movie, he does it. He pays Favelle the money, telling him to keep it a secret. But then, of course, Danvers shows up in court the next day, telling them what happened and how Favelle basically blackmailed Maxim and that Maxim was paying to keep this note a secret. And they have a check showing the money that he had given to Favelle. And so that was just completely changed weird as well, the fact that he agreed to pay Favell to keep this note a secret. But this in turn ends up having Maxim be put in jail. And so then it is like on the narrator to figure out what happened with Rebecca. Why was she seeing a doctor? And so it's on her to investigate and to stand up for Maxim. And then in the end of this movie, Mandalay is burning. And then the narrator, which we see Danvers setting the fire in this movie, which in the book, it's like insinuated that it was Danvers, but we don't know for sure. And in the end of the book, Danvers is still alive. Anyway, the end of the 1940 movie, she dies, but she dies in the burning home, in burning Mandalay. So here she sees Danvers on a cliff and she goes over to talk to her. And Danvers like says something mean to her, saying how like, oh, you'll never be happy, blah, blah, blah. And the narrator is like, yes, I will. And then Danvers jumps off the cliff and dies. And so that was just kind of a weird interaction and I didn't enjoy it. And with the narrator in this movie, like I said, she is much more assertive with Danvers early on. And then it is on her to like clear Maxim's name. And so it is just very different from the book, right? Because in the book, she was, throughout most of the book, she was just so like timid and naive and living in the shadow of Rebecca, who is like just this formidable force of a person. And the book is called Rebecca. The narrator doesn't even have a name. And so you leave the book and the 1940 movie with Rebecca as being a character you remember so well, even though we never even see her in flesh and blood. And yet she's just such a presence that the narrator just can't escape from. Whereas here, like, I guess in the 2020 movie, maybe they wanted to make the narrator more like applicable to today's audiences. And so they made her stand up for herself more and made her more of an important character in clearing Maxim's name, I guess. But by doing that, it's just changing the whole point of the book, right? And in the book, like you had Rebecca, she was the strong female role in this who did things her own way and didn't care what society said. I mean, she did care because she and Maxim put up a front acting like they had a great relationship, but it was like for her own benefit. So she used people for her own benefit and success and to do what she wanted and to live the life she wanted. But yeah, in this 2020 movie, like the narrator is like the main character here. Like Rebecca feels like an afterthought when that's not the case. Rebecca should be like front and center, and that just wasn't the case with the 2020 movie. Also, the 2020 movie ends with them living in the hotel, and it has a voiceover of saying something about how like true love is something to walk through fire for, and we see them just living their best life, being happy, which is also very different from the book, because in the book we see them living in a hotel after Mandalay has burned, and they're just living a very mundane life, and we see that the narrator is still like, she's grown and she is more assertive than she was at one point, and she's not as childish. And you know, throughout the book, we're always getting these fantasies she has, and so she's grown up in some ways, but she is still like subservient in a way to Maxim, and she talks about how she will read to him, but she knows to avoid reading certain things that will upset him or that remind him of Mandalay. And so it still is kind of a similar relationship that they had earlier. And yeah, basically the 2020 movie has them have a relationship that you can be rooting for, whereas in the book, like I was never rooting for her and Maxim and like their relationship. Like there were just a lot of different issues in that relationship that make it not one that you are excited about. Whereas the 2020 movie, definitely, like I said, they made their relationship something that you wanted to succeed and you wanted to see them together. And then also one other change that I thought was really odd is that Favell, when she meets him at Mandalay, when Maxim is in London, Favell is alone, not with Danvers. He tells her he is there to see Danvers, but then the two of them go horseback riding together and they seem to get along great, which is very different because in the book, she sees him with Danvers and she doesn't like him and they have this weird interaction. And yeah, here they get along, and then she confronts Danvers and she's like, hey, why did you invite Favell here? So again, just standing up to Danvers much more than she ever did in the book. Because in the book she does, but it's not till the end. So yeah, basically, like it would be interesting to watch this movie without having read the book or seen the 1940 movie. I'm not sure what I would have thought about it then. I think I would have been confused maybe why it's called Rebecca, because yeah, Rebecca just isn't the prominent character that she should have been. And so I assume I probably would have liked it better had I not read the book or seen the movie basically, but because I have, ultimately I do not think the 2020 adaptation is worth it. The acting was fine. Like I said, I feel like some people were miscast, but as far as the acting, their performances, I think Armie Hammer was probably the weakest link. So he was miscast because he was too young, but I feel like he doesn't give the best performance ever. And the movie is pretty. You know, like it's in color, whereas obviously the 1940 movie was black and white. And so it is cool just seeing their outfits and seeing Mandalay in color and everything. But yeah, ultimately, part of me is confused why they even made it, because they didn't like change anything enough in order to merit a remake. you know? And so I guess that's ultimately where I end on this movie, is I'm just kind of confused. Anyway, wouldn't recommend this movie, didn't love it. 1940 movie, fantastic. Book, fantastic. Highly recommend both of them. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know your thoughts down below. Let me know if you have seen either of these movies and if you like them and how they compare to the book in your mind. If you do like the 2020 movie, I would love to know your thoughts down below as well, because I am curious to hear what other people think of this movie, especially if they do like it. So don't forget to like and subscribe, and thank you again for watching, and I will see you next time.